government conference on how to report climate issues were the same ones who, quote, debunked the ClimateGate emails, saying, move along, there's nothing to see here. An American, Michael Mann, originator of the hockey stick metaphor that Al Gore made famous, was involved in about 15% of the ClimateGate emails. Efforts in the U.S. to get access to the emails written by Mann on University of Virginia computers, with grants funded by taxpayers and used to create public policy, met with the same kind of stonewalling and lies that had been seen in the U.K., that the documents had been destroyed when in fact they had not. What were they afraid of? Well, their efforts to hide the decline in global temperatures are now open for everyone to see, as are their dire predictions about the imminent disappearance of polar ice caps. There is a 17-year trend of global cooling in spite of record increases of carbon dioxide, what they call carbon. Both Al Gore and NASA scientists predicted that the polar ice caps would be gone by 2013. Yet, when UK climate scientists, accompanied by a BBC reporter, thought they could bolster their failing narrative by measuring ice in the Antarctic in the summer, they and their rescuers were trapped by record ice. The Gilligan's Iceland fiasco was spun as a weather aberration rather than a climate trend that matched 17 years of declining temperatures. The BBC dutifully reported that the Antarctic ice was only 1% above normal, when in fact it was at record levels, 15% above normal, and the UN organization pushing global warming as a crisis can't explain it. The government is deliberately trying to push society into a fantasy crisis so that they can justify a global tax regime, create a scarcity of energy, and gain global control of energy use. And they will conspire, blatantly lie, and cover up real data in order to forward that agenda. Well, stay tuned. Right after the break, Anthony Gucciardi is going to interview Dr. Group about biochemical contamination, what it does to you, and what you can do about it. Stay tuned.
Symbols are powerful, and the globalists have hijacked the symbols of America. They've turned them into their own symbols. Well, we are restoring the idea of the true republic, not the counterfeit globalist empire, by promoting the icon George Washington and others. That's why we're rolling out an 100% made in America line of incredible pro-liberty apparel. We are repopularizing liberty. We are helping fellow Americans rediscover what made this country great. We are the spirit of 1776. We are 1776 worldwide. We are all brothers and sisters in arms in the animating contest of liberty in the long march towards humanity's ultimate destiny of freedom. Visit madein1776.com today and vote with your dollars to promote truly made in America, high quality products, and promote the ideals of liberty. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
There is no question that there is, by definition, a conspiracy to mutate and attack the biology of humanity. And specifically, we're talking now about the assault on our hormone levels. The key thing here is that masculinity is now almost dead in this nation of the United States. Masculinity has been assaulted and feminized from estrogen mimickers like BPA, so on and so forth. And if there's one man that knows really what's going on, who's been researching this and telling me stuff off the air that blew my mind, it's Dr. Edward Group, who's been studying this for 2 decades, specifically with the attack on masculinity, but also the attack on women as well, with the hormones completely out of whack, insane emotional responses that make no sense because your body is under such assault on a daily basis that we don't know what we're even thinking about oftentimes. And that's why we can't understand politically what's going on as well. So Dr. Group, thanks for joining us. And, you know, tell us about specifically the root of this attack, how it ties into eugenics and what's going on.
Well, a long time ago, even, you know, before the 1940s, when, you know, the German scientists and the Russian scientists wanted to, and the big companies like the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds wanted to put together a eugenics program because they saw that the world would be overpopulated in the future. They wanted to create ways to control the population. And the way that you do that, one of two ways, is you either increase the death rate or you decrease the birth rate. So they put things into action to decrease the death rate. Obviously, we know that with different types of chemicals, and they're killing us off with pharmaceuticals and stuff like that. But the big thing is the fact that they're manipulating the hormone levels in the body, and the fact that they're decreasing, or the plan anyway, is to decrease the birth rates. Now, how they're doing that is through many different ways. You know, the oil and gas industry, which created different types of polyesters and oil and gas type derivatives, which led into plastic development, et cetera, those are all endocrine disruptors. And the creation of the majority of chemicals out there, including the heavy metal toxicity, the way that they designed to attack the body was they knew that the pituitary gland, the pineal gland, the thyroid gland, the adrenal glands, all the glands in the hypothalamus, the thalamus, those are what regulate your sex hormones. Those are what regulate all the hormones. They knew that every cell in the body needed hormones for regulation. So they knew also about testosterone. And that's why I call this pretty much eugenics program, the Operation Testosterone, because the more that I get into this, the more things that I see. I mean, you could open up your cabinet in your kitchen and pull out eugenic stuff that mimics testosterone, suppresses testosterone, or increases the estrogen. Those are really the ways that they're trying to do this. And it all started, you know, with trying to also, that's one method, is that they're trying to reduce these hormones. The second method is they're also using genetic manipulation. They want to manipulate the genes. The third method is division. They want to separate the males and the females. They want to break up the families because they don't want strong families. They don't want you to be creating healthy babies over and over and over again. So those are the three methods. The first one, through chemical warfare, dates back to Agent Orange and dates back to the chemicals such as pesticides. I mean, pesticides are some of the most extensive and damaging hormone disruptors that completely reduce the testosterone levels. How does this all come into effect, though? I mean, it really comes into effect when you ingest all these things in the womb when the baby's growing, because all children start as a female, which is very interesting when the eggs divide. And then only with the introduction of testosterone do the ovaries form into testes, and the clitoris forms into the penis.
And just the slightest amount of hormonal changes, though, can wreck the body. But we're talking about an assault from BPA, the estrogen mimicking chemicals, that are like tied in almost every single study, 90% of the studies, every woman with breast cancer has this inside of them. So it's a complete attack. It's a barrage on the gates of our biology. And that we're talking about something that's so finite and so minute that even the slightest change could ruin our health.
Even the slightest change. I mean, you know, who knows what we're going to see generations from now and generations from now and generations from now, but what we're seeing right now is we're seeing literally the feminization of the country, the demasculinization. I mean, we're having a lot of miscarriages, actually, because the female fetus is a lot stronger than the male fetus. And when it, like just after 9/11, when there was so much stress, we had an increase in miscarriages of males because stress has a lot to do with that. Obviously, the adrenal gland is a stress hormone, and it's still your hormones are off, and it affects the endocrine. When I say endocrine disruptors, you know, we're talking about things that increase estrogen and decrease testosterone. But endocrine disruptors also disrupt other hormones inside the body too. So what we're dealing with is the mothers that are eating soy products, for example, using personal care products, using antibacterial soaps that have triclosan in it. I mean, all these petrochemicals, all these chemicals that are going to disrupt their natural hormones, from shampoos to makeup. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. They're constantly exposed to this. This, as well as birth control pills, which was another method of reducing the population by increasing estrogen concentrations, all these things tied together are going to alter the fetus. Now, when the fetus inside, if there's not enough testosterone, then the fetus is going to turn into a female. If it turns into a female, that's great. There's in, like in Peru, because of all the petrochemical companies down there dumping things in the water, they're having 8 women to every 1 male right now. So they figure the least males on the planet, then, you know, usually males are the aggressive ones. You know, it's easy to control women, and it's easy, you know, women are pretty passive. But if they have a lot of aggressive males, you know, those are the ones that can challenge them. And that's the main focus, is to dumb the males down. And the problem with fertility is usually with males, because 50% of males have low sperm counts, and 80% have sperm that doesn't swim the right way, or it's not in the proper form, or it's, you know, not, you know, correct as far as being able to plant that seed, because the sperm is going to determine whether it's a male or female. But then also, once the fetus is in there, it's going to change into a male or a female.
Well, you notice there are a lot of studies on this and scientists, and they're always trying to look for some outside immediate source without thinking about the chemicals, the plastics, the BPA, nothing. They're always just thinking, well, you know, it might be genealogically that we've come to this point through evolution that we no longer are having fertility rates skyrocket and all this stuff. When they're saying now infertility is such at a drastic amount that within the next 1,000 years we could face extinction, and this is ramping up over and over again. Why do you think? Is it just because they're paid off? They're not even referencing things like BPA.
Well, it's, you know, the media doesn't want you. The media is behind it too, because the media, it tries to separate males. They only report on the divorces. They only report on all the bad things that males are doing. They're reporting on the kind of
and
things that manipulate society through media. And, you know, the men, which are becoming so feminine, and they're, you know, they were born with smaller penises or whatever, and now they're lazy, they don't want to work as much. I mean, it's harder to find a job, it's harder to find men. Like if you go back 50 or 60 years when men really had higher testosterone levels and they were willing to work, and they were, you know, they did, you know, their pheromones that they were releasing were attracting women. And now the pheromones that men are releasing are actually attracting men and not really attracting, because the alpha male is becoming more of a submissive type of a male, because they have higher estrogen levels. They're getting man boobs. You know, they're having a hard time with erectile dysfunction. They're having a hard time with impotence. I mean, all these things are affecting the male, which psychologically affects the male's alpha male ability to have confidence and approach women and everything else. And so it's easier for a male now to sit at home, play video games, be lazy, watch porn, and not, you know, put himself out there, or not feel like that testosterone-based male.
I think that's key, though, at a societal level. When we look at what's going on, a lot of people think ideologically the society is warped, which it is. But chemically, we're so imbalanced and we're so attacked by all this garbage in the food supply, the GMOs, the BPA, and all of it, that it's really biological. It's really physically we're changing, and that's altering our mental state. So if we break this down enough, I think that really explains why society is where it's at.
Tune in to PrisonPlanet.tv for an extended broadcast.
Now you can watch The Alex Jones Show live as it happens at Infowars.com/show.
You'll find links to all of our content there and a free 15-day trial for Prison Planet TV.
More than 60 movies and documentaries all in one place at InfoWars.com/show.
We have a serious problem right now. We have little girls thinking they're boys, and we have little boys thinking they're girls, and we have the majority of the population that can't even get pregnant. You know, we have low testosterone levels in, you know, 80% of the males, high depression. You know, suicide. We have prescription medications like statins, which are causing low testosterone levels. I mean, if you look at the majority of the problems that we're facing right now,